Now that we've discussed the new user interface, the new timeline, and how roles and subroles work, we're going to move on to cover a variety of additional improvements.
That's right, Steve. And since you've been discussing audio, we'll start with great new ways to quickly edit your audio. So in this project, I want to focus on editing the dialogue audio. So I'm going to open the timeline index, and I'm going to focus on the dialogue right here. And then I'm also put that dialogue in its own lane. Now, I'm not going to the component level here because there's only one component. There was one mic used for both actors here. So I'm just going to stay at this level. And I've already done some audio work, but I want to add some fades to these different pieces of audio between each of the actors. Now, under the Modify menu, under just volume, we have two new commands, apply fades and remove fades, which are great, but they don't have keyboard shortcuts. So let's assign them. I'll go to Final Cut Pro, Commands, Customize. And the first thing I need to do here is create a new set. So I'll choose Duplicate and give it a name. I'll call it Warp Speed Audio Editing and click OK. Now those commands had the word fade in them, so I'll search for the word fade. And down here they appear, apply audio fades and remove audio fades. But two additional commands appear here as well that aren't available in any menu, toggle audio fade in and toggle audio fade out. So let's set keyboard shortcuts for all of these. I'll select the first one, apply audio fades. Fade starts with an F. I'll see what's available with the F key. And if I scroll down, Option and Command are available. So I'll press Option Command F to apply that keyboard shortcut to this command. Now for removing audio fades, I also want to use the F. And if I scroll down, I've got Option Command along with the Shift key available right here. So I'll press Option Command Shift F to apply that keyboard command. Now to toggle audio fade in, I'm still going to look for something with an F. And I have Control Option available. So I'll press Control Option F. And then for toggle audio fade out, let's see if Control Option Shift is available. And it sure is. So Control Option Shift and F. So kind of logical commands that use the F key with modifiers. And by adding the shift, you basically do the opposite. So with those set up, I'll press Save, close the command editor. And now let's look at a couple of examples of how to use these. I'm going to zoom in tight to start with, and let's say all I want to do is create a crossfade between these two audio clips here. So for the clip here, I want to add a fade in. So I'll press Control Option F, and I get a fade in. I'll select this bottom one, Control Option Add the Shift key, and press F, and I get a fade out. And just like that, without dragging on the mouse, I've created a crossfade. Now, if you want to change the default fade duration, if I go to Final Cut Pro to Preferences, in the Editing pane, we now have a new option to set a fade duration. So I can change that to whatever I want. I'll leave it where it is for now. Now I'm going to zoom out with Shift-Z. And let's say here I've checkerboarded this audio because I've created overlaps and I want fades on all of them. So by using the keyboard shortcut, Command-Option-F, I can immediately apply fades to the in and the out of every single one of the selected clips. We'll zoom in a little bit and we can see those fades applied. In the trim menu, there's a new command, Align Audio to Video. Once again, let's assign a keyboard shortcut. This time I'll press Command Option K to go to the command editor. I'll type Align in the search field. And there's the command, Align Audio to Video. I'll select the A key, and Option is available, so I'll press Option A to assign that keyboard shortcut, and press Save, and close the command editor. So here I have several clips with overlapping audio, but let's say I don't want them to overlap anymore. Previously, I would need to drag each of them and snap them back to match the video clips, but now, with the keyboard shortcut, all I need to do is press Option A, and every single one of those selected audio clips is automatically trimmed to match the duration of the associated video clip.
Mark, it's great that we finally have a way to quickly create crossfades.
I agree. Now in this next lesson, I'm going to look at some effects-related features.
Awesome. Let's take a look.